Ladies and gentlemen, if you're allergic to awesome, please leave. These guys are called 1040, and they're from Bowling Green State University. Give it up!
As 1040's origins, we were not the first male a cappella group on campus. To my knowledge, that was the Hebe BGs. That was the male a cappella group, and they were directly affiliated with the University Men's Chorus. So all the guys in that group were only from the Men's Chorus. They did kind of the same thing we do, a cappella arrangements across all genres. And then as time went on, guys made friends and branched out outside of Hebe BGs they wanted to have in the group. But since there was that affiliation, they couldn't be in the ensemble.
They were founded in the fall of 2010 as 1040. They became an independent group. Still many of them are in the Men's Chorus here. And they renamed themselves 1040 after the room in the Musical Arts Building where the original members met.
This is year 11 for 1040, and we're as strong as ever. I've been in 1040 for 3 years now, and this is my first year as president, and what a year it's been.
Say you don't know me, or recognize my face. Say you don't care who goes to that kind of place.
My main duties are making gigs happen for the group, so we'll have people contact us through campus, like Ziggy-thon today we're singing for them, or charities in the area we go make performances for them. So I'm kind of the liaison between people that want to hire us for gigs or also the university, making things happen with them, like be it videos, stuff like that.
Be our guest, puts our service to the test. Tie a napkin around your neck, sure you will provide the rest. Sweet pleasure.
So I'm the vice president of 1040. Mainly what I do is help the president, so obviously Troy the Fever. I help him out with whatever kind of he needs to do. Itinerary purposes for our tour is kind of what I'm helping him with right now, getting in contact with people. It's mainly just Troy's right-hand man is what the vice president does in this group. Different social events that we do, getting gigs set up if I need to get gigs set up or set out. Some different emails to getting in contact with people for doing that. That's kind of my main role that I've done so far this year.
1040 is definitely the most different music experience I've had. I think it's different because it's all run by students. Everyone kind of has like their own mutual respect for each other. Instead of one person listening to one other person, it creates kind of like a collaboration instead of one person telling us what to do.
So, hi, I'm Taj Crowder. I am the music director of 1040. I've been in this group for about 4 years. And I'm a junior/senior. I take a semester off. So a general rehearsal, we usually give guys some time, give guys some leeway to kind of come in, enjoy each other, hang out, let everybody get here. People have different obligations. So we usually start in between 9:05 to 9:10, depending on how many guys we have showing up, especially considering the situation we're in this year, it may be 9:15. We usually warm up for anywhere from 10 to 15 minutes, make sure everybody's ready to go.
1, 2, 3, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 5, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4,
And then after that, it's chart after chart after chart. And if we're in a situation like ICCA's, we'll be spending a lot of time on that one chart. Or if it's like a retreat, we'll be able to spend an hour just really workshopping that one chart. It becomes tedious, but that's what a musical rehearsal is. We usually find people that can help the group out that are in some way, shape, or form affiliated with the group, or someone knows someone that can help us with choreography. So in the past, we've had dance majors do it. We've had people that are in UDA do it, and they kind of sit down with the either the exec board or just the people that'll be running those rehearsals, and hash out what can be done in a musical setting. In comparison to last year, this year with COVID being the main thing that's guiding our rehearsal time and our rehearsal space, we've had to find different spaces where we're allowed to and find different times where we're allowed to. It's kind of been, everyone's figuring everything out at the same time.
Now we can sing indoors in groups up to 20, so that's perfect for us. We are socially distanced, we comply with everything. The one really weird thing is that there's a limit of 30 minutes on the room. So after 30 minutes, we have to stop, take a break, and let the room air out. Then we can go back inside and continue rehearsing. So it's been strange for sure, but we're kind of rolling with it and doing what 1040 does.
The conversation on the masks is tough as a vocalist. I am personally a vocal performance major, so I spend a lot of time in lessons, mask on, mask off, certain distances, and it makes it tougher to hear. You have a certain volume that you're used to singing your whole life that you now have to bump up a dynamic, if not two, to make sure that your sound not only projects but is also quality and is your authentic sound.
The audition process is pretty simple. Usually Taj, which is our director, takes a snippet out of a solo, and then say there's four people auditioning for that solo. They would just sing that part while everyone is singing their own respective parts.
2, 3, 4.
Last year we had about 20 to 30 people come to audition, so that, at least like my first year, that's how many people we had. We had about 20 to 30. We were hoping to get at least like 10 for our auditions this year, and we had about 15 people that came, so that was a little better, but again, I think it just kind of hurt a little because of COVID, or like we couldn't get the word out enough, or we couldn't go on campus and spread the word more.
But yeah, with COVID, gigs are a lot different. We don't have as many as we typically do. Usually we sing for like opening weekend on campus or other events as well for the faculty. But with the pandemic, that hasn't been happening. So one big thing that changed for us is every year we compete in the International Championship of Collegiate Acapella. It's a big in-person event where they draw groups from all across the country. It's a really, really big event for us, but this year it was all virtual. So the biggest COVID challenge we experienced was making our showcase translate to a screen with no live audience. So that was a little odd, but we did grow as far as video editing, audio editing. We're learning how to improve our social media presence as well. So while COVID stinks with less appearances in person, we learned a lot as a group on how to do more things online. So
I've got myself a notion, and one I know that you'll understand, to set the world in motion by reaching out for each other's hand.
a cappella in its own, one, you don't have accompaniment, so it's all voices. In that regards, particularly, you're going to talk about the vocal percussionist, who our vocal percussionist, Sam Brown, Michael Carter, do an absolutely incredible job of making sure that they're keeping our beat with just their mouth, which is very tough.
I'm Sam Brown. I am a junior right now. I have been in this group for 3 years, and I am the vocal percussionist slash beatboxer. So how I got into beatboxing was a long time ago when I was about 10. We noticed that there was this movie coming out called Pitch Perfect, and it was all about acapella and like stuff around acapella. And I love, you know, doing music and like listening to acapella stuff. There's one method that like we normally learn how, like mm-hmm. we as like a community of beatboxers. But it's like the boots and cats method. It's like you say boots and cats over and over, and then you just like slowly start taking syllables away and like words away, so it like becomes. And then you can go ham on it, and you can start mixing up like. And it all like stays throughout the same rhythm, and that was like one of the warm ups and like stuff that really got me into doing it more like fundamentally.
Say singing a cappella is more fun than personally than other choral experiences.
In a pop a cappella setting, you get to sing music that you've always dreamed of singing.
A cappella, you can sing fun songs from the 80s, you know, like Roll with the Changes, Eye to Eye, stuff like, you know, fun, upbeat pop music.
Here I've been able to perform Stevie Wonder on a stage other than in front of my mom and her aunties at Thanksgiving. So that's always a blast. There's just so much freedom to express yourself in an authentic way.
What I enjoy most about 1040
is how we can kind of phase off from practicing and have a little bit of fun and then phase back in.
The changes it's had on me as a musician and as a singer, a lot of obstacles came with it, but I also learned a lot musically.
Definitely the brotherhood.
The music, everything we sing here is a bop. Everything that's written here is a bop. It's awesome.
Making music and making friends at the same time.
It's the brotherhood and the music making that we're able to create.
It's just the vibe of the group.
Really the community, because anytime I come in and I'm having like the worst day of my life, I will always leave a 1040 rehearsal smiling, and it's just a beautiful process.
The atmosphere, everybody. Music is one of my favorite things in this world. Getting to do it with this group of guys has been one of my favorite experiences my whole life.
We love each other, and you can hear that in every sound that we make. And I'd have to say throughout every year at 1040, that's been my favorite part. Ja, ja, da, da. Ja, ja, da.